First carry for James Conner. And they're able to get this one across the 35. That's a pickup of 11 and a first down on their first offensive play.
Well, as we've learned over the years, just because a guy plays left tackle doesn't mean he doesn't have run-blocking abilities. And we just saw it there. Controlling the line of scrimmage created a big game.
That's kind of a bonus. He's there to protect that high value that you have back under center, but he creates space in the run game.
Yeah, not only can he dance, he can mash, too.
That one good for 37 yards. All right, Charles, let me put you in the head of one of those defenders out there. You have a big play like that go against you so early. What, does that shake your confidence?
It shouldn't, but it often does because your thought process all during the week.
Oh, Conner loses it. But I think a Cardinal was able to gain possession, yes, so they will hold on to the ball.
Wow, that ball is not free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. Almost like, it's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home, the next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. So they keep the ball, but work to do on second and long. Caught by the tight end Ertz. Touchdown, Cardinals. Zach Ertz, 31 yards. And the Cardinals get the upper hand as they're on the board first here this afternoon. Prater for the extra point. And that makes the score 7-0. After the touchdown, out is Prater to kick. And they'll bring it out to the 25 as Agnew elects for the touchback. Bringing the Jaguars up first and 10 at their 25-yard line. They'll start on the ground, ETN. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. 23 yards on the pickup there and a first. Looked like they picked a heck of a time to run the counter.
And we've been saying that in this great game of football probably since we started playing. Anytime you get guys thinking you're going to go one way and you hit back the opposite side, it's a great chance it can turn into the type of play we just saw there. A big gainer.
And a good run here as he'll rumble all the way down to the 40-yard line. Another good gain. That's now 35 yards combined on those last two plays. On first and 10, it's ETN. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop it behind the line. That's going to go as a loss of 4, and it'll be second down.
When people talk about plays being blown up, that's exactly what they're talking about. That's Exhibit A for physical play.
They'll have to deal with a second and 14 now after the loss. Now Lawrence. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Partner, what we're seeing so far is the defense is certainly coordinated. Both levels doing their jobs in tandem. The back helping the front helping the back. The pressure got home on that last play and forced him to try and throw through contact and short of the sticks.
Now the throw on third down, knocked away and incomplete.
Nice back-to-back plays defensively. They're stacking momentum now. One incompletion, two incompletion. They're going for more.
On fourth down, on is Logan Cook to punt. And he'll back up a few steps as he'll make the fair catch at about the 8-yard line. 31 yards on the punt there. And the Cards are going to have the football with a first and 10 deep in their own territory. ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. They have to be thrilled with that first drive that got them the touchdown. Now they'll be looking to make it a two-score advantage here on the road.
And you know, they spent all week in practice, in meetings, talking about taking an early advantage. Being the road team, going up a score, that takes the crowd out of the game and puts some doubt in the minds of their opponents.
They fake the handoff. Now Murray. His throw is going to be incomplete.
That was an interesting look there, because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them, and I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
And he stopped immediately there. Officially nothing on that one, no gain, so they're left with still 10 to go on third down. He's already put it on the ground once in this first half. There are no gain, just struggling to get going.
Yeah, and what he needs right now, a dose of confidence, which means his guys have to chop a hole, a big one for him, give him a chance to run a little bit, and gain some of that confidence back. He didn't get it.
Murray fighting, lost the football, and they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line.
You can't admire his willingness to sacrifice his body to try and pick up the first down, and I do. But let's face it, you know his coaches are going to warn him about diving or extending for a marker for this exact reason. So much easier to have the ball knocked free when you're extended like that. So if you're going to dive, you got to make sure you secure the football, which he didn't.
On the counter, ETN. And he's got some space here. And he'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. 53 yards rushing for him as he's got the afternoon off to a great start.
When they came into this game saying it was important that they set the time and show that they can run the football, I believe that they've done that here in the first quarter.
On first down, right back to ETN. He'll get forward for three down to the 16-yard line.
They went right back to him, but he pretty much had nowhere to go on that play.
Yeah, the previous carry looked pretty good. That one, maybe he was a little tired. I don't know.
Yeah, maybe he should have tapped out and had a second back come in and maybe make that run. Who knows?
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven. And they'll go again with ETN. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the five at the six. 9 yards on the play there, and it sets him up first and goal.
Usually we see runs like this as the defense breaks down later in the game, but this guy is setting the tone early, running through all types of tackles and putting the defense back on its heels.
And they'll run with ETN. It's a 5-yard pickup that time on what will wind up being the final play of this first quarter. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Yeah. Second and goal from the one.
On the goal.
ETN. He is not going to get in here as they push him back to the 2-yard line. It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down.
Sometimes you get all those big guys down there in one spot, and there's just nowhere to go. And in this case, the defensive tackle used his strength and swallowed him up.
Third and goal from the 2, and they're going with a jumbo set offensively. They'll try to run with ETN and trying to shake free, but ETN cannot. The defense will stop him short. Going for it, here's ETN. And take this one in for the Jags touchdown. Travis ETN. It's a 1-yard touchdown run, and the Jaguars' decision to go for it pays off with 6 points. Extra point by Patterson, up and good, and we are tied at 7. So I'll leave it at 7 now as they kick it away. And they'll put up the stop sign there as his guys will get it the 25. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. Last time out, they had the fumble. That led to the touchdown. Not a great look on either side of the ball as the defense gave up the points too, Charles. But they've got to take care of the football and do better here on this possession.
It's certainly been a tough stretch, partner, for both of those units. And they kind of put their defensive mates in a really tough spot there by dropping the ball on the ground. But an easy way to make it up to them, get out there now and get some points on this drive.
Again, it's Connor, and he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It'll be a loss of a couple on the play, so that third down coming up.
With his size, he's a tough man to bring down, but they do a nice job there stopping his progress and not allowing him to get back to the line of scrimmage.
And the Jags with five in the secondary now on third down. On third down, it's Connor. No gain on the play. Maybe I'm wrong, but it looked like even if he had opted to keep that, I don't think there was going to be much to gain.
Seemed like it was perfectly defense. And know what they say, those guys on the other side, they get paid too.
On fourth down, here's Andy Leon to kick it away. Jamal Agnew is deep to return it. Taking it about the 16. A big kick that time, 52 yards. And the Jaguars go on offense, first down and 10. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive.
The offense coming back out here. Plenty of energy, ready to roll, looking to just add to what they have been doing after scoring a touchdown, Charles, their last time out.
And that's a great feeling to have on the sideline, partner, knowing you just won the battle against the opposing defense. And since they came off the field, I'll guarantee you all they want to do is get back out there because they know they have the upper hand on that defense right now.
On second down, ETN once more. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. 87 yards rushing for him as he has been tough to stop here this first down.
Give every member of that unit a ton of credit for ripping off such a big gain there, because you don't get free for that many yards on a counter or misdirection without everybody selling the heck out of it.
ETN up the middle. Room here to run. There he goes, right side. Touchdown, Jaguars. And always a good first half when you can hit pay dirt twice.
And it never hurts to have that good feeling as the game moves on. Just think about halftime. If this is all he gets, he'll just sit there at the half and think, all right, two already. I can get some more. I can get some more. And he'll be encouraging his offensive line to create some space.
Extra point by Patterson, up and good. And that makes the score 14-7. After the touchdown, Cook now to kick this one away. And there will not be a return here. It's a touchback, and it'll come out to the 25-yard line. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. That 7-0 lead of theirs short-lived as they've now given up two straight touchdowns to fall behind by 7.
Yeah, but no cause for discouragement here. Yeah, they've fallen behind, but haven't they proven that they can go down and score? So what was the formula that got them down there the first time? Get back to something close to that, and maybe they can get this game tied up.
And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and eight coming up.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
The last run got a couple here, second and eight. To throw, it's Murray. This will be swung out here for counter. And he'll be brought down inside the 40-yard line.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. They're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much since. They'll fake it to counter. Now Murray. And Murray in trouble here, and down he goes. Brought down by Trayvon Walker on the pass rush.
Even keeping the back end for extra protection on third down, they still couldn't prevent the sack. Now it's fourth and long thanks to a terrific individual effort on defense.
Company going for it on fourth. The catch made by DeAndre Hopkins. And they are into field goal range now as he's got the first down at the 26. Both sides were holding their breath there on that fourth down play, and the offense can breathe a sigh of relief.
And both knew exactly where the first down markers were. You know the defense is trying to guard those sticks and try and keep people in front, but somehow, some way, those guys found a way to pick it up.
On first and 10, here's Murray. And a dangerous throw there as that's knocked down and incomplete.
It sort of looks like they stalled some fight in them on this series because it seemed like things were headed for the red zone. But this defense gets two more stops. They can keep them out of that area.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Here's Murray as he sets to throw it. He'll get this to Connor underneath. And he's going to be marked down just outside the 10. The Cardinals going to use the first of their timeouts as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open, just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space, and it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
Now Murray again. Can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. So maybe just a momentary setback on what's been a great drive so far, but second and 13 here. Another try after the first down sack. Murray. Pressure, and they got to him again. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. This will be a 37-yard attempt. And the 38-year-old vet able to split the uprights, and that will do it for this first half. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. The Jaguars in possession of the lead, and they will get the football as we are underway in the second half. And no return here for Agnew, so they'll bring it out, start the drive at the 25. The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. But Charles, for them, pretty good first half on the ground. They had some success running the ball in quarters one and two, and they've got the lead. Now a chance to expand upon that lead here for their first drive in the third quarter.
Yeah, believe it or not, you and I have noticed that this great game of football has shifted towards pass first, run second. So for me, it's really nice to see some of this team keeping the ground game as a big component of their offense, and it's working pretty well for them now. And let's face it, they can continue to do damage with it. And in addition, it sets up the pass game really well for them, too.
Give them three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
Not a lot of running room there. Not a place to make a cut and kind of exit out because they had everything bottled up. Looked to me like the linemen were taking on their blocks really well and giving up no creases.
The last run got three. Now here's second and seven. Another tote for ETN. And a good run here as he'll rumble all the way down to the 40-yard line. 186 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football. Sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
Straight ahead, ETN. And he's got room. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling.
They're making it look easy out there. Another first down. So far on this drive, let me do this a little bit of math here. Four plays, three first downs.
That's a pretty good recipe for success. A give to ETN running right. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
They had three tight ends in that formation. That's almost a universal sign that they're planning to run the football. But how about the defense there? They met force with force and caused a stack up behind the line of scrimmage and threw him for a loss.
A rare misstep on that last play because the drive has been strong, but now it's second and 12. And now they'll throw it with Lawrence. And his pass incomplete.
It certainly didn't appear that that's where he wanted to go with the ball initially, so he tried to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. They go play action with Lawrence. Looking for Jones, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Byron Murphy. And the Cardinals are going to have a short field here as they'll take over right at the 50. So it was a drive that had real promise here to begin the third quarter, but ultimately derailed by the INT.
And that was the position you wanted to be in, coming out to start this third quarter, get a nice drive going, looking for the end zone, possibly got a little bit too greedy right there.
5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Oh, that was a thing of beauty right there. Look at how quick those blockers fired off the line once the ball was snapped. That was an O-line on a mission, all in sync, and the defense is lucky. That play only picked up 5 yards.
After the pickup of five, here's second and five. On play action, it's Murray. Zach Ertz has it complete. Touchdown, Cardinals. Zach Ertz, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Cardinals have retaken a third quarter lead.
So a very strong first drive in the second half, Charles, as they've turned that halftime deficit into a third quarter lead.
And they were pretty purposeful there, weren't they? Measured in their approach. But boy, they executed awfully well moving the ball down the field.
Extra point good by Prater. And it's now 17-14. After the touchdown, out is Prater to kick. And they'll bring it out to the 25 as Agnew elects for the touchback.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. As this offense takes the field against CD, remember last drive, they were moving the football, but then they threw that costly interception, so we'll see if they can right the ship here on this drive.
And doesn't that just sum up football? We see it all the time, don't we? The defense goes from losing the battle to making a huge play and stealing the momentum. So you know they're riding high right now, and they're ready to challenge this offense and that quarterback one more time.
And we'll see if the offense is up for that challenge here as things start to get more interesting here in the second half. Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run. ETN once more. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. This will be a loss of three, and now a much tougher third down looming.
Well, Brandon, he's had a great day, but sometimes the other guys make a play against you. What's that expression they like to use in the NFL? Those guys get paid too, you know.
Yeah, in college they say, hey, they're on scholarship too in the NFL. They're getting paid too. With the day he's had, you can have one go in the wrong direction. A pretty good effort there. 9 yards, but not enough. We'll likely see the punt team now on fourth down. They'll try and run for it. Get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. A curious decision to go for it, but it pays off with a first down. Backed up where they were on this side of the field. That was a gutsy call.
A gutsy call that never should have happened. Not so much them going for it. That's their decision. But where's the defensive front? Where's the leverage? Where's the low man wins? Where's getting into the offensive backfield and spilling the play? How did they permit them to pick up a first down in that situation?
Here's a give to ETN, and he'll get it across midfield and down into Cardinal territory. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five. A handoff running left is ETN, and he'll be brought down on what's going to turn out to be the final play of this third quarter. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with this third down play as we've played three quarters. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. A field goal from this spot likely out of the question. They've got to get closer here on third down. They'll run with ETN, and he is going to lose yardage here. A 3 yard loss, fourth down now.
That's a really alert defense there because they saw the heavy look come in from the offense, countered it with extra linebackers who brought a little bit of speed and heft, and able to really make a big time play for their defense.
On fourth down, they'll try and run for it. And he's not even going to come close to picking up the first. They stop him right at the line of scrimmage. The Jags come up empty on fourth down. And this defense will take over right at midfield. So they've converted their first two fourth down attempts. Not there. Now they're 2 for 3.
You think maybe the offense coordinator expended a little capital on that one? You know, when you're 2 for 2, you can lock it for that third one, right? Didn't get it there. Maybe now the head coach might not.
Murray has it knocked loose. Fumble. Second time in this game, Charles, the ball is squirted out from his hands. Luckily, his teammate was there to pounce on.
You're right. Got the lucky bounce, able to retain possession. You know, we often talk about the combine and why do we measure quarterbacks' hands. Is that really a big deal? It's for situations like this. Do you have the hands big enough and strong enough to hold on to the football while being jostled?
The fumble on first down. Now here's second down. To throw is Murray.
Locates Ertz going across the middle. And he'll be brought down on the other side of midfield at the 43.
And that was yardage that they needed there after the sack on first down. They didn't get all of it back. And now they look at third down as a manageable situation, one that they have a much better chance of picking up.
The Cardinals on third down, 0 for 3 to this point. They could use a conversion. Here it's third and 3. That's complete to his running back, Connor. Touchdown, Cardinals! James Connor, 43 yards! And the Cards are able to build on to their fourth quarter lead. Prater on to add the extra point. And his guys will take a 10-point lead.
It's the score, Cardinals 24, Jaguars 14.
After the touchdown, out is Prater to kick. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. And the script really is flipped for them. The momentum on the other sideline, and now they have to try and battle back from a two-score deficit. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
I think they want to start getting back into this game. It behooves them to get better on first down.
Yeah, certainly not what they were looking for there out of the opening play of this drive. The last run good for 2. Here's second and 8. Lawrence. He'll get this out to the flat for ETN. Calling a gain of 3 on the play. And it brings up 3rd and 5 now. They'll need 5 on this play to move the sticks. Lawrence will throw. ETN bringing in another one. That he's brought down short. 2 yards there. Needed 4. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. You're tackling them almost on the spot. That means they have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
Giving to the big tight end on 4th. And he is not going anywhere. They stop him for no gain. He needed 2. He barely got back to the line of scrimmage. Then the Cardinals will now take over with excellent field position. So they'll come up 1st and 10 now from the 33. On the counter, it's Connor. And he'll manage to pick up about 4. It's 2nd down. The Jaguars going to go ahead and use their first timeout. It's just their first. They'll be down to 2 remaining as we step aside here in the 4th quarter. The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. They'll stay on the ground with Connor again. And he'll take this down just shy of the 25-yard line. 3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other 3 here on 3rd down?
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down.
And intercepted. Maybe the turning point they need. Picked up by Andre Sisco. And the Jags are right back in this football game. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive.
A kind of a lucky break on the prior drive, Charles. The turnover on downs that the offense had didn't come back to bite them after the other side, their defense came through, was able to hold them without any points.
I would agree with you, partner. A little bit of a lucky break indeed, but you know what they'd say to us? No luck, just pure skill. We rose to the challenge, and we didn't permit a score. That's how we roll.
Well, I'm kind of curious, Charles, if they might temper their aggressiveness now offensively if they get in that 4th down spot again.
Yeah, one would think so, but maybe because they held them, they might go for it again.
They come up now 3rd and 5 following the incomplete pass. Throwing now, Lawrence.
Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And this is intercepted, and that should do it.
Isaiah Simmons picking it off. And the Cards are going to have the football here at their own 35-yard line.
Well, we knew this was going to be a tall order anyway, down two scores with this little time remaining, but that interception puts it in to any hopes that they had.
All right, partner, work with me here, because obviously scoring a touchdown, getting the onside kick, then going down, scoring again. Well, that's asking a lot, isn't it? And that's really not a great expectation to begin with. I think they'll look back on this game and see what got them in this spot in the first place and say to themselves, we really gave this game away.
Back to throw it, Murray. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means he'll need to come up with something here on third down. To throw. And too much juice.
I think it's safe to say he's made some questionable decisions out there so far. Forced some throws into tight coverage. He's already been picked off in this game. Fourth down now, but he was fortunate on that one not to have another turnover on his ledger.
Here's the veteran punter Lee as he sends this one away. Yards on the punt there, and it'll be Jaguar football as they take over deep in their own territory. The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. They might be thinking this is close to a lost cause here. Got to play it out. What do they need to do?
Well, they have a thought process in mind already, but they can't get ahead of themselves. They know that they need to score quickly.
Yeah, two-score game.
Onside kick and get the ball back and then score again. But they can't worry about the last 2 points. The only thing that matters is scoring quickly, then they'll take it from there.
Here's Lawrence. Able to find Jones. And they're able to get this one across the 35. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. Meanwhile, Lawrence's throw here into the hands of Jones. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. Another first down as they call his number again. He's got 15 yards here. Lawrence. He'll get this off to ETN. And they're going to get this to about the 44-yard line. The Jaguars now will use the last of their timeouts as they get it with just 19 seconds left on the clock. Coming up on a second and 6. Back to throw. Lawrence. Looking in zone for Jones. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
When you're leading in the final quarter, your radar has to be up for any potential deep shots. Probably not the last one they're going to see in this game, not as long as they hold this lead.
On third down, Lawrence. Looking in zone for Jones. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
Give him big credit for his coverage right there, because when he saw the route break deep, he stayed in position to prevent a completion while avoiding any risk of a flag.
Ready, break.
A final shot now for Lawrence. One last shot at the end zone. And this is intercepted, but they'll say out of bounds. So very close to a turnover there in the end zone. So the game will continue for at least one more play.
To not finish a game on a defensive penalty, that's why they get one more untimed attempt.
Ready,
Final shot. They'll look to throw. And a little bit of a consolation prize there. He's into the end zone. Won't win him the game, but they do get the score with all zero showing.
But some fantasy players are really happy with that score.
Problem for them, they needed that score with a little more time left on the clock. I think just too little too late now.
I would agree with that. We're programmed never to say never, but in this case, we're asking a lot for them to even think they have a chance.
And he missed it. It wouldn't have mattered. They were going to lose either way, but the game ends strangely on a missed PAT.
What a finish in this one, Charles. You know, this group, they come in, they have to fight a hostile atmosphere every snap. They get the late score, they get the victory, and that flight home, it's going to be a little sweeter after this one.
And Brandon, just like you, I was fired up for that last sequence. How about that? Wouldn't you have loved to have been in the huddle when they were mounting that game-winning drive? Big-time moment. No one shied away from it. They tuned out the crowd, kept their heads, and executed the way they needed to earn that win.
Pushing my buttons, this ain't no game to me, yeah. Ain't got time to be explaining me, yeah. I'ma just take over the game, baby, yeah. Let me show you how to be a star. Let me show you how to go far, far. Let me show you how to shine bright. Let me show you how to shine bright. Let me show you how to raise a bar, how to go large, how to take it too far. Let me show you how to show up. Show out and surf the crowd. Trust me, you ain't never seen nothing like this. You ain't never been to a show like this.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL has us at newly named State Farm Stadium in Glendale, Arizona. Coming up, we've got a good matchup on tap between the Jacksonville Jaguars and the Arizona Cardinals. Here now to get us started is Logan Cook, and we are underway here on EA Sports. And we will not get a run back here to start. It's a touchback, and it will come out to the 25.
Something safe, something they're confident about, something they feel good. And once that's completed, then you just keep moving from there because the confidence elevates.
Maybe a good spot to take a shot here, second and a yard from the 34. Murray now. He'll get this complete to Rondale Moore. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49.
Murray to Moore for the Cardinal first.
Slant route's effective no matter who's running the route and catching the ball. But when you have a receiver of that stature, you have to be a little bit more precise throwing it. You don't have the same catch radius with the bigger targets.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Here's Murray. He's got his man. That's Ertz downfield. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. 25 yards that time. They'll run for the first time with James Conner. And he's brought down, but not before a gain of 13.
Last big practice beforehand. You go through your offensive script. You go through your play calling. You go through all the stuff and establish things. And it looks like it's going like clockwork right now for them.
From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. They stay on the ground. Here's Conner again. And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. Second down. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick, quick, quick. And what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
And he'll go down, brought down at the 20-yard line. Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game.
Well, talk about a rhythm breaker right there. They've been moving the ball well. Drive had started beautifully. That one's going to hurt.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Touchdown! Kyler Murray with a touchdown throw to DeAndre Hopkins. And the Cardinals will jump on top with the game's first score here this afternoon. Now Matt Prater for the point after. And the kick makes it through, but flags come flying in as well. It appears we're going to get a roughing call tacked on. And that flag accepted. After the roughing penalty on the PAT, they'll kick off from 15 yards further upfield. And no return here for Agnew, so they'll bring it out, start the drive at the 25. Lawrence bringing the Jaguars up first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Now ETN to start the drive. And if there was a lane there, it closed up quickly as he stopped for no gain. Second down.
Now that's a mountain of a man that just made that stop, isn't it? But he's more than that. This guy's nimble and quick. More than a space eater, he just made a great play there.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again second and 10. On the counter, ETN. That's some space here. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. Last play, they got stuffed at the line. Different story here, over 20 yards.
Dance class, anyone? Did you see the steps between the quarterback and the running
back
on that counter
play? You need for a good counter.
You have to have it because you're setting up your blocking. There's a timing element as well, but they have to marry up their steps. Otherwise, that timing gets thrown out the window.
Timing was great there and a big run. On first and 10, it's ETN. Good cover defensively as they get to him just beyond the 45 after the juke. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and 9.
Not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped him. Marked that down for a win in the defense's column.
On second down, a run with ETN. And that one blown up quickly as he's going to be stopped before he can even get started. That's a big loss of 3, and it brings up third down.
Sometimes it's a danger putting that jumbo set out there. You just get a lot of bodies massed in one location. You could wind up with 18, 20, maybe even all 22 in the box, and there's nowhere to run the football.
The Cards going nickel. An extra defensive back out there now on third down. From the gun, it's Lawrence. Oh, that's into double coverage and intercepted. And the Cardinals are going to get the football here at their own 40-yard line.
Probably we ever had to start Icarus in the college. That's the guy who flew too close to the sun and had his wings melted. That was our guy right there. Keeps pressing it and pressing it. Finally, on that throw, he paid the price with that turnover.
The drive will start with Connor. And some room to run now. And he's got this to the 30 before being taken down. Heck of a start, a 30-yard pickup on their first play from scrimmage.
What did you see there on the defensive side? What allowed that good size run?
Well, they're in a cover two alignment, which means your two safeties are back away from the line of scrimmage. So if you can match up your blocking at the line, at the point of attack, there's usually some room, a big gap between that second level and third, and that's what they were able to exploit.
And he'll take this one in for the Arizona touchdown. Zach Ertz, 30 yards. And the Cardinals are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead.
And they have to be loving this start to the first quarter.
Well, the way that they're going, it means they're about two touchdown drives already. They feel very confident and feel like they have all the answers in this game. They're 1 point away from going up 14 to nothing. Maybe they press the advantage and go for two.
Prater for the extra point. It's now 14 to nothing. 14 nothing to score. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Here's Prater now set to kick it away. And they'll bring it out to the 25 as Agnew elects for the touchback. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And they're in an early hole. The first drive, they threw the interception. That led to a touchdown. So, decent-sized deficit early on.
It is, but I think you hit the key words, early on. So they have to decide, do we even need to change game plan? Or do we just need to execute better and try and get back in this game? Defenses always talk about earning the right to rush the passer on third down. And you know what offenses want? Win first down so that can set things up for themselves better.
And that wasn't helpful there. Not a big impact on first down. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a third down and six. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is, and really a lot of the time they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance, they're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain. Well, they sent the power set out there, and their job is to be man-on-man and move people so they can run the football. But that time, too many men didn't get moved in the box defensively. They end up throwing him for a loss.
Fourth down. Here's Lawrence. Flush to his right. And it's going to be batted down. And we'll go the other way with a football. Boy, a curious decision to go for it. Doesn't pan out. And the Cardinals will now take over with excellent field position. Murray a give. This is Connor. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but a guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Connor going to get it again on second down. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. 60 yards rushing for him now, and he's carried the ball just 5 times. He scored touchdowns on drives 1 and 2, and now they're trying to make it a perfect 3-for-3 to start. Murray getting this out wide to Hopkins. Touchdown, Cardinals! Kyler Murray with a
Yeah.
Turn me up.
Yeah. Hey, check it. Okay, I feel unstoppable. Losing's impossible. Go against the team, the thing they know not to do. Bright lights, game on the line. Do what I gotta do. Time after time, we do the impossible.